Here locally, in the aftermath of a deadly officer-involved shooting and protests in Frayser last week, the community is trying to regain a sense of normalcy following the violent protests. As the authorities continue their investigations, community leaders are working to help the healing begin. And with more on how they plan to do that, Pastor Ricky Floyd from the Pursuit of God Transformation Center and State Representative Antonio Parkinson, who represents Frayser and another part of Memphis as well. Thank you so much for your time. So where do we stand in terms of what can be done just to, number one, help Frayser heal, but also to send the message that this is not necessarily Frayser. The violent protests are not Frayser.
Well, I'm glad you said that, because one thing that happens is, if you may remember a couple of years ago, Mayor Beth, when the national media came to Frayser because of teen pregnancy and infant mortality
rate. I do.
It gave us the opportunity to show measures and things that we already had in place. It actually, what was a negative turned to be a positive, because they found out we had systems in place, but we were not just able to make people aware of many of the things that we are doing in Frayser. So we are turning this negative opportunity and to a time to express positive things that we're doing, and we're adding some things as a state representative just put together for us last night.
And that's important, because you do represent, you work in the government, but you also represent individuals, so you sort of have to bridge the trust gap, and there seems to be a large one to bridge. You know, do you do that?
You know, at the end of the day, Mayor Beth, you know, we're fathers. You know, we are our community members, regardless of our titles. If you stripped our titles away, we still live in those communities. We still have to interact in those communities, and we still have to be part of those communities. And you know, most of the things that we do are community driven. You know, such as last night, what we did in yesterday in announcing to put mental health counselors in the churches in the Frayser area, so the people have access, quicker access, you know, closer to home. We understand, you know, some of the struggles, the challenges that happen in our communities, such as transportation and those issues. And so we just have to be solution oriented in our approach, and make sure that the people are taken care of.
One of the reasons citizens will listen to both of you, but particularly as a member of the government, you, Antonio, is because you have worked in the community for years and years and years and years, long before you were a state representative.
Right.
How would you advise the mayor, you know, and other officials to handle this, who may not have spent time in the trenches building that long relationship? What are they doing right, and what perhaps have they not done enough of since the shooting?
You know, I think the big difference is the fact that we have lived the life of what the citizens are going through in our community.
Right.
That's a huge difference maker.
But he is mayor. Mayor Strickland is mayor. So whether he grew up with a silver spoon in his mouth, which by the way he did not, but you get my point, or not, he still represents folks. So how does he handle that?
He does. And I think it's important that he gets with the people that have the experience of living in those types of environments.
Like yourself.
And so that credibility is there. And that's the difference maker, is having the credibility to be able to go into those communities and be able to speak the language and speak to the people and understand and empathize, because you understand, because you've been there, what they're going through.
Does it make a difference that it was federal marshals, really? It was not a member of the Memphis Police Department.
That really makes a big difference, because the potential for tension between Memphis Police Department and our citizens was on the edge. But when you look at what happened in Frayser, here's what happened. You had U.S. Marshals who were not from the Frayser community, and you had, I call, agitators or activists, whichever you want to talk about, that were not from the Frayser community. Our community lost an image, our community lost property, our community lost a life, all because of entities that were not from our community. I want to look at a different perspective when you say the political figures. Most of the transformation that you've seen in the Frayser community has happened because we have churches that are united. You have churches in the Frayser community that employs 200 people. Right. You have churches in the Frayser community that houses 50.
In other words, it's not people. Because of political.
So, no, it's because of the unity, all of us working together, the politicians, the pastors, the policemen. We have a relationship with Colonel Sanders. And so Colonel Sanders is not just the police, He's our friend that happens to be a police
who has
that
lived
cares
and worked
about the community. And so we've formed a coalition that's unified and on one accord.
So what does the community most want? There will be those who will just instantly assume that the young man was in the right and that police acted too fast. And there will be other folks, perhaps outside Frayser, who assume that the police are right. What do you want?
Right or wrong, we don't want another young man's blood to spill on our property by the police, by another black man, by a white man. We want Frayser to become known as a place of life, of resurrection, of peace, prosperity, purpose, where we're giving hope and helping people to transform their lives.
Well, thank you for your work in doing that.
All right.
Thank you.